Everyone, this is Honeywell, and we're playing Stardew Valley. In the last episode, I decided to change the layout of the fields. So pretty much for the next 3 days, that's all we're going to be doing. Because we still have those crops growing, so we kind of have to work around it. But if we leave it all to the last day on the 28th, I don't think there's any way that we'll be able to get it done. Like, those are really big fields. So, yeah, our day is pretty much planned for us for the next 3 days. Probably the next 4 or 5 days is going to be just work and more work. Very displeased. Sorry to hear that. It is Clint's birthday, and he likes artichoke dip. So we're going to give him that. Usually I just give him topazes, just because they're easy and I always have them available. Albacore? Sure, we could do that. But since we have that, like, chest of food, I might as well give it to villagers who would like it, is what I'm thinking. Okay, we want that. We probably want the coffee. Let's put that there. Oh, our milk pail. Probably want that. And we are going to upgrade our watering can, so we'll want that. And that. What else do we have going on here? You know what? Let's get all of these winter seeds out. Well, all of the winter forage. I think these next few days would probably have been done better as no commentary kind of episodes, but it is what it is. Okay, do we need any of that? No. Do we want to process those shields? No, we really don't, because then we'll have to sort through the stuff. 7. And we need copper. Okay. I see how it is. Let's get Miss Daisy, and we'll do the rounds like usual. Except we'll be hopped up on some coffee. So much to do. So much. I was kind of hoping that I could spend these last few days, like, working on the paths and all that good stuff, but that's not gonna happen. I think it's gonna be all fields all the time. Which is fine. It will make me happy. Hang on, I'm coming. I hear you. Do you know what? I'm gonna milk that goat on the same day as the mushroom cave. and see if that works out to be a good plan. Because the goats are every other day. The goat products are worth more. And they're less work. So, yeah. This is fine. We don't need to do more than this. This is good enough. I still haven't looked up the iridium quality milk to see how much it sells for. I mean, it's possible it could sell more than just regular Gold Star cheese. Okay, looks good. Have a good day, ladies. It's almost spring. Almost. And I don't like this keg here on the end. For some reason, it bugs me. It doesn't look nice to me. Oh, and Gus wants an albacore. But you know what? We're not even going to see him. What else? Gus wants an albacore, an amethyst to Emily, 10 hardwood for Robin. I think we're getting quite the collection of quests for the villagers. Cheese, ale, mayo. We need 480, so 470 in winter seeds. Okay, that is good. Let's go wish Clint a happy birthday and do some stuff. Sunshine, how are you today? Well, I guess if you don't like your job, you're welcome. Let's do, how much, we just need 25,000 for our watering can. That's good. And upgrade our watering can. And this is the last of our tools. Pretty pleased about that. So we'll have all of our iridium tools by year one. Hey, Pam. I'm sure she is good. Figures. I just got rid of the snow yams. Okay, we're not going to get to that today. Miss Daisy, I guess you can stay right here. Hopped up on coffee so we can try and do this as fast as possible. And if I can't get these fields redesigned, the only thing that'll mean is we'll miss out on, instead of getting 3 harvests of rhubarb, we'll only get 2, and that'll probably cost us probably 400,000, which sounds like a lot, but it's really not. We're going to be, we should net over 10 million, and we don't need any of that. Like a lot of our big expenses are already covered, you know? Let's take down all of the scarecrows and put them in the proper places. And let's get rid of these, because as you run up and down the fields, if you have plots on the ends, those would be easy to accidentally put some seeds you don't want in there. Okay, here's a scarecrow going here. Oh. For the love of God. Okay. So it's this row. And, yeah. Rip crops. Scarecrow here. And then a scarecrow on the last row. Two. Scarecrow here. Okay, that is good. More coffee. And then a scarecrow here. We do. Let's just save that. Okay. And then we need another scarecrow here. And then we need one right here. 2, 4, 6. Let's grab you. Okay, that is good. These are going to be boards. Nothing on that one. Boards. No, don't run off now. I don't really want to destroy these crops because that would be, I mean, we spent a lot of time on these this winter. I'd like to get the money for them, but... Okay, let's... make up these kegs, and then what are we gonna put? We could do. I wonder if hops would be ready. Or you know what? We could do coffee. What do we need? 64? 27, 28, 29, 30. So we can do 120 coffee beans. Let's do some coffee. Is good. Because I just put away all the copper. Dur, dur, dur. This go, Miss Daisy. All of the next episodes are going to be like this, by the way. Very little commentary. I almost considered just cutting out the middleman and not turning on the microphone just to just to kind of reinforce that. but I figured anyone who's watching is an adult enough to turn the channel if they're not having fun. Okay. Looks good. If I've showed you guys this pattern that I'm gonna do or not. I haven't seen anyone else use it, which is probably a bad sign. Because if it was nice, it was probably already been done before. but we'll try it and see how it goes. All of this is subject to change. And I wanted to do something kind of like nice and cute with these fields, but I don't think it's going to happen this year. I think there's a reason why the nice farms are like year 4, 5, 6, 7, 10 sort of thing. Because the days are short. And it's also hard to tell what this is going to look like in the other months, just because the color is different. Like, during like the spring and summer, the color is much different. Okay. That is done enough. Is there any of these I can take up? That can come up. Duh. Oh wait, no, I need to check for sprinklers. Okay, sprinklers would go there. That would be a sprinkler. No. A sprinkler would go here. Okay, so all of this can be hoed. Okay. Too late. I missed my chance. And these are just placeholder crops so that we can just scythe down at the beginning of the season. I'm not gonna bother collecting that coffee. What is it, 1 o'clock? And none of those jars and everything are gonna be ready because yesterday was Christmas, or the Feast of the Winter Star. So everything will be a little bit off. Let's see, sell those. Oh. Looks good. Let's go to bed. You know, all early. Oh. I mean, let's pass out in the living room. we got a little bit of money, which is good. We should get a nice bit of money from selling all of our winter forage. Like, the crystal fruit won't be included in that. But the other stuff will. Okay, so we already saw that. Sometime today we're gonna have jars and kegs to refill. Other than that, we're gonna keep doing the crops. So it'll be another little low commentary day. Good humor does not matter. Let's start our day right. Bean hot pot. Thanks, Clint. That's really nice of you. Yeah, let's just do the rounds like usual. Hey, huh? And it'll be mushroom day. It'll be mushroom and goat day. So we'll get them all synced up. And I don't... These aren't going to be ready, but let's just check. No. Okay. We'll check again, Well, I guess we'll take care of the animals. Like, finish doing our little rounds, then check again, and then we'll get right back to the fields. You know, like we do. Hello, everybody! Two more days. Two more days and you'll be outside. It'll be lovely. Good morning, ladies. And, for a change, it really is morning. If we need to, we'll kind of, like, have to let the animals take care of themselves. But, I'd like to do a better job of seeing them every day. You know. Thanks for the goat's milk. Do I need to sell goat's milk? I do, so we're gonna sell that. Unless I'm just... Yeah, here it is. Goat's milk and then larger goat's milk. Okay. So that is just gonna be sold. One, two. Is that how many we have? How quickly I forget. Yeah, five. Okay, the cheese away. We're selling that. These we want on our top bar. Okay. And we'll finish up on our lovely little dock area. I do like this. Not yet. I didn't want to pick those because even though the jars aren't ready, they're it's a nice reminder that let's just sell those. It's a nice reminder for me to go back and check on these. That can go away, and we'll start smelting iron. Oh, do you know what we should do? What are we gonna need? Fifty-one-two. And then I think we have 112 kegs now. Another thrilling day of farming. I'm a little disappointed I'm not going to be able to get the like the floor patterns started. I mean, there'd be no way I could have finished it, but I was hoping to start it so when the spring comes and all the grass grows back and the rocks and all that stuff. Like, I was hoping to have it kind of go back in the places that I wanted it to. But that's alright. Okay, let's, oh, Robin must be done with the barn, because everything's messed up. And I think there's something under that. Yeah, there is. Well, that wasn't really smart. Oh, we have to put wine in. And then time. Thanks, George. Is that all the kegs? Looks good. You know what? No, because I don't want this one here. And again, this isn't the optimal layout. You can fit more in there if you do it a different way. But I don't like them. Like, if I have to go in there, I prefer seeing, like, nice, neat, orderly lines. So non-optimal is good for me. I don't know. Maybe as the farm goes along, I'll change it, but... For right now, I'm good the way it is. Five, six, seven. I think this is right. Five? Yeah. Scoot over to the dock. Messing up, even though I'm going like super slow. I don't know what we're going to keep filling these with. Three, four, five. Okay, that's right. Oh dear. You're moving underwater. For some reason, we decided to hoard fabric. We'll, Okay, pickled pumpkins, cranberries, coconut wine, crystal fruit wine. Away candles, and let's go stash the rest of our starfruit wine. Oh, do you know what? I'm not gonna like this. That's I mean, if we're not gonna fill it, we might as well have like is there room for these? Yeah. And then in the beginning of fall, we'll uncask all this. Where are the hitboxes? Oh well. I tried. One at a time. And then we'll decide if we're going to do like an optimal 125 cellar layout. Or if we're going to fill up the entire cellar with casks. Do not know. Okay, let's get back to the fields. They're not going to plant themselves. Okay, this is wood. And this is sprinkler. 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 Right. Oh, I guess I should have hoed it all first. Okay. Moving right along. Come up. One, two. This can come up. Iridium sprinkler. Iridium sprinkler. Iridium sprinkler. Iridium sprinkler. Iridium sprinkler. Okay. And then the rest is crops. This isn't like the best way to go about this. Like, it's taking more time to do it this way, but I don't think we'll have enough time to wait until everything is grown and harvest and then plow the field. So we're doing it as we go along. Sprinkler, 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 sprinkler. Bedtime. Will we make it into the house before we pass out? Ah, so close. So close. And another little bit of money. You can see the difference here. Like the 47 cranberries are only worth 13,000. There's so much better things you could be spending your money on. On the other hand, 50 crystal fruit wine was 31,000, which is not bad for a forage crop. And another 52,000. And on that note, and the very last day of winter and year one, we're going to end the episode. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.